Hi guys, it's Claire. Welcome back. Today I wanted to talk to you a little bit about The White Book by Han Kang, which I read earlier this month and which was just recently longlisted for the Man Booker International Prize. It was translated by Deborah Smith, and this is the third Han Kang book I've read so far. I read Human Acts and then The Vegetarian in close succession back in December, and I really loved Human Acts and had mixed feelings about The Vegetarian, although the farther away I get from that book, the more I've come to really appreciate it. But all that's to say that I went into this book not really knowing how I would react to it. Reading this book felt kind of like being gently nestled in the palm of someone else's hand and feeling all the wonder and the grief and the beauty and the pain that both plague and also give meaning to life, and was just a really exquisite, beautiful book that really blew me away in ways that I wasn't expecting. And it's hard to say what exactly this book is in terms of, is it a book of prose poetry? Is it nonfiction? But it seems to be a very autobiographical series of passages and reflections, starting with Han Kang's account of the death of her older sister, who was born prematurely and lived only a couple of hours. And Han Kang describes that event in a way that is really haunting, because her sister was born when her parents were living in a rather remote and isolated place where they didn't have access to a telephone or to readily available transportation, and her sister was born when her father was at work and her mother, who was only 22 at the time, was home alone and had to deliver the baby alone, and then had no way of calling for medical help. And while this book isn't about just that event, it is the foundational story of Han Kang's own life, because as her mother tells her later, she likely wouldn't have been born if her sister had survived. And so the death of her older sister is inextricably bound with her own life, and her own life story in some ways seems to be written over the ghost text of the life that her sister never had a chance to live. And she contemplates all the things and the people who come before us, and how all of the random conditions of the past come together to make the present possible, but how tenuous all of that is. And this book contains a series of striking images that really capture Han Kang's feelings about the improbability and the fragility and the transience of life and existence. One of my favorite passages about that is a section called Wave. Standing at this border where land and water meet, watching the seemingly endless recurrence of the waves, the fact that our lives are no more than brief instants is felt with unequivocal clarity. Each wave becomes dazzlingly white at the moment of its shattering. Further out, the tranquil body of water flashes like the scales of innumerable fish. The glittering of multitudes is there, the shifting, stirring, tossing of multitudes. Nothing is eternal. I think that image of the crashing wave beautifully captures some of the many dualities that Han Kang grapples with in this book. One of those ideas being that life can be this wave of glittering immensity even as it is already crashing towards its inevitable end. She also reflects on life's ability to contain both beauty and pain. The scene of her sister's death, for example, is an ugly and bloody one, but her mother also later describes the baby's skin as being beautiful and white as a moon-shaped rice cake. Han Kang also explores how everything vanishes and falls away eventually, but she also considers the ways in which the past is essential and is always present. She breathes in her sister's dying breaths in the same way that someone else will breathe in her dying breaths. In a similar vein, the future is certain in that nothing is eternal, but the future is also this white void that is unknowable and limitless. And I just love how she explores all of these opposing ideas and how she considers the ways in which life contradicts itself constantly. And Han Kang's use of white is not arbitrary. On a scientific level, white isn't actually a color. Rather, it's what the eye sees when all wavelengths of light are reflected back at us. And so white, like life and existence itself, is not just one thing, and in fact contains multitudes. And these are definitely big themes and heady ideas that Han Kang is grappling with, but what I love about this book is that there is a quietness to it, and Han Kang exercises real restraint in terms of the details and images that she chooses. And for those reasons, the book never feels overstuffed or overwrought or overly self-important. And it also never feels like beautiful imagery or beautiful writing for their own sake. There's real feeling and reflection behind every detail and every image. I also want to note that Deborah Smith's translation, at least from my English speaking and reading perspective, is really stunning. There are a couple of places here where Deborah Smith translates idiomatic Korean phrases as they are, and she doesn't try to find a different English equivalent. So she'll use a phrase like laughing whitely that exists in Korean but doesn't really exist in English. And I really like that because I like to be able to sense the presence of the original text beneath the translation. And in a book that reflects so much on the different layers and multiple meanings of life, I thought the layers to the language and the imagery and the translation in this book was really thematically appropriate and beautiful. In short, I really recommend that you check out this book if you have access to it. I really, really loved it, and I say that as someone who is not usually a huge fan of experimental literature, but I found it so open and so accessible, and it was just a glowing and beautiful book. If you've read this book, I would love to hear your thoughts on it. Please leave them in the comments below, or if you've read any of Han Kang's work, let me know what you think, because she is definitely one of my recent favorite authors. As always, thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time. Bye!